Hello everyone, welcome back to Coding with T. Today we are going to create the second video of our playlist, Riverpod State Management, and we are going to cover the basics of Riverpod in this tutorial. We will create a project and try to create our first provider and then use that provider inside our user interface and see the results. As you can see, we created this playlist. We created this playlist into two phases. The first phase has three sections. The second phase also contains three sections. Whereas if we talk about the first section, this is the first section video. And as you can see, we are going to cover the static provider. So this is the main topic, and also we will see how we are going to use these providers to display our data in the UI inside our widgets. So let's head towards the tutorial. First of all, you need to create a new project. I have already created a new project called Riverpod Tutorials, and I'll drop the down below in the description if you want to download this. First of all, before proceeding anything else, you need to create a new project that is already done. And if you are new to the project creation and you don't know what is Flutter and how to create a new project, you can watch the previous videos. I'll drop the link down below in the description, or you can simply head towards Coding with T and watch the relevant videos. Okay, now the second most important thing is we need to use this package, which is a Riverpod package. Name is Flutter Riverpod. So we have to copy this package, and in the project go to the Pubspec.yaml file. Right after the dependencies, make sure you have only two spaces from the left side. So if you see, we have one and two spaces, then you are going to paste your dependency. Once dependency is added, click on pubget. Now inside main.dart, we have, you can see the default code generated by the Flutter when creating a new project. So I'm not going to go for the counter in this project. We will create a counter app in the next tutorial, which is the state provider. But for today, we are going to create a simple provider. So I'm not going to create a new class for that. So first of all, inside the main.dart, you can see we do not have anything written. So to create a provider, provider is, as I told you in the previous video, providers are the core features of Riverpod, and Riverpod mostly depends on the providers. And what are the providers? Providers are basically a function. You can call it a global function, a function which is not going to be written inside any class. So we have to write the providers outside the class without any boundaries. We just have to create a provider, but we will definitely, with passage of time, we will see how to manage these providers in large projects. So first of all, to create a provider, I am simply going to write a variable. So this variable is going to represent each provider uniquely. So I'm going to name it static, and by norm we have to write provider next to it. So static provider. And now if I'm going to write a provider, you can see we have a package, Flutter underscore Riverpod. So this is the package that is going to be imported, Flutter Riverpod, flutterriverpod.dart. And now inside the provider, to create a provider, first of all, add a semicolon. I told you that each provider is actually a function, right? So if you create a provider, you can see it is saying to create a function, as every provider is a function. So inside this provider, what we have to do, we have to just create a function like this. Very simple. We do not have to do anything else. And inside the parameter, what we have to pass is the ref object. So what is this ref object? Let me add it first. In the previous tutorial, we learned that we have a provider scope which is wrapped on top of everything, which contains all the providers. So provider scope is something that is going to handle all the providers globally. And I'm not going to go into details again, but definitely you should watch the previous video. And on the right side, we have a widget tree. So we are going to create a provider, and that provider will go inside the provider scope. So this reference object is actually from the provider scope, so that we can easily find that provider and use that provider inside our user interface or wherever we want to use. Now you see, we created a provider, a simple provider, in which I'm going to return, let's say we are going to create a string provider, string type of provider, which is going to return a string. I'm going to name it hello world, a simple string which is going to be returned. A static, let's say name it string, static string provider. And we do not have any class yet, so first let me create a stateless widget. Again, let's name it the same, my app, so that error should be gone. So we have a class my name. It is a stateless object. And now in order to display the provider, we have to do some modifications to display any kind of provider. But first of all, remember that we have to, inside the run app, before starting the widget tree, we actually have to wrap this my app with provider scope widget. So this is the provider scope which is going to handle each and every provider specifically for the Riverpod. So now this provider will automatically be handled by this provider scope, and we can use that inside our project wherever we want. So for now, we have the provider, we have the provider scope. So we created a provider which is a string type provider, and now we want to utilize that provider inside our user interface, inside our widget. Now to do that, what we have to use is, we have to remove this stateless widget, or we have to replace this stateless widget with the consumer widget. You see, I just replaced it with a consumer widget, but under the hood, it is still a stateless widget with some additional features added by the Riverpod team. And now inside the build method, you can see we have an error. It means that we can use the context, but along with the context, we have to add one more thing. You see, this is the widget reference. So this is a kind of similar thing, but only dealing with the features that are related to user interface. So if I'm going to write widget ref, let's name it again ref over here. You see the error is gone. So this ref and this ref are kind of similar, but this reference is focused on the providers because this reference is not going to be used inside the user interface. So this is not related to user interface and this is not related to the backend logic of the provider. Rather, this widget reference is going to be used to utilize any provider, right? So now we have to utilize the provider. To use any provider inside any class or any user interface, we have to create a variable. Let me create a variable. Let's say I'm going to name it string. Now to call the provider, we have to use the ref object. Remember that we have over in the build method as a parameter. So we have two methods to call any provider. The first one is a read method so that we are going to read any provider or the data from the any provider or whatever that provider is doing. So we can read that. There is the second provider, which is watch. So by name, you can see read is going to only read one time when this widget is going to be created. So when this build method is going to be executed, it is going to draw the user interface. At that time, the read is only going to work once. It is not going to redraw anything again whenever there is change in any provider or whenever provider data needs to be redrawn on the user interface. So it is not going to do that. So we are not definitely going to go for the read at this stage. Rather, we are going to go for the watch, means the watch is going to listen for the changes of this provider, whatever provider we are going to provide over here. So let me copy the provider name, paste it over here, and we are done. Now this reference is actually start listening to this specific provider. And you see, this is a reference inside the build method. And whenever this is going to be destroyed, the listening will stop listening to that provider and automatically disposal will occur. We do not have to dispose anything manually. And also there is another thing. If you are coming from the GetX background or the provider background, remember that we have to use the context, provider dot of context. So we are not going to pass any context over here. And the second thing is, in the GetX, we have to first create the dependency injection. We have to handle all the things manually, get.port, then get.find. So dependency injection is again a piece of cake, I must say, for the Riverpod, that it handles so smoothly that we do not have to worry about any get.port, get.find. We just have to call reference.watch and boom, we are going to now watch whenever there is change inside this provider. Automatically this value will be changed and this consumer widget is going to redraw the whole widget tree again for us. Okay, now let's display the text. So I've created a scaffold, but first let me wrap the my app with the material app so that we can use the material features, and it will be home widget. Okay, now inside the scaffold we have a center object. Next we have the text. Now in the text we want to print this string, and if you hover over the string, you can see it as a string type, or let me change the name to result something. So this result is actually a string type because you see we are returning the string from here. So now this provider is a string type of provider. So we just have to now write result, and because it is a string, text widget requires a string, so we do not have to change anything. Now in order to see the data, I am just going to run that in the Chrome because while creating this Flutter project, I choose to have iOS, Android, and web. Okay, our application is now running and you can see the result. It is printing in the center hello world, which is coming from the provider. So this is actually a static provider. We cannot change this provider, but what is the use of this provider? Some of the videos out there, they are saying that this is not a useful provider, but this is a very useful provider. You can see later on, because this provider will be used to create instances of different type of repositories. Let's say you want to use the repository, you just have to create a repository instance and you want to handle that repository or the class or any controller later on. You want to keep your memory free. You want to handle each and every case of that class by the provider. So you just have to create this simple provider, and instead of this string, we are going to return, let's say we have the auth repository. And then we are going to change the name this to auth repository provider. And then that specific class will be start treating as the part of a provider. So for now, do not have to be worried about anything. We will cover each and every concept. So let's say I'm going to create another in type of provider, and it is not going to return the string. It is going to return, let's say, some number. Same like this, we can create any provider with any return type. Let's say you have some model that you want to return, you can create a model, let's say a user model, then you have some values in it, you can return the user model from here and the provider will be start acting as a user model. So you see we have int provider, double provider. So same way, we just have to call the result. We can even call multiple providers inside a single build object using the ref. So if I'm going to use all these three providers, I just have to copy these names, change the name to result int, result double, and we're going to use them. So let's say I'm just going to concatenate it for the demo purpose. We have the result int. Int should be in double. So, and same way we have the result double. So we are going to add all of these things. And now you can see we have hello world 26.65. So this is how we are going to create different type of providers. So in the next video, we are also going to talk about the dynamic provider, which is going to be a mutable. This is not a mutable. This is immutable. We cannot change the state. All the providers are basically immutable, but definitely we can use the state provider to change its values dynamically. And we will see how we are going to even trigger some button action, and we will definitely be able to change the provider values. So that's it for today's tutorial. If you have any question, you can ask me down in the comments, and again, drop the complete playlist link in the description. So once again, if you have any question, you can ask me in the comments. Thank you for watching and take care.